Right. Well, unfortunately, Egypt is on record as one of the countries that violates the rights of journalists the most, and they are at it again, sending two journalists to jail. And they are saying that they spread false news. Any substance in that?
Well, it's quite questionable what's actually going on in Egypt regarding the falsity of the news that was actually and that led to the sentence of those journalists to like a 2-year sentence in jail for propagating what they call false news. Now, you know that Egypt, as the Amnesty International has said, that they passed some of the most repressive laws when it comes to human rights over the past few years. Now, we know what happened in Egyptian Spring, Arab Spring, whereby Egypt was affected, Mubarak was overthrown, even in Tunisia also. Problems happened there. And I believe what the Egyptian government is trying to do is that they are not learning from history. Because they are, if you fail to learn from history, you're bound to make the mistake twice. What they are doing is what got Mubarak out of power, what got him out of office. Mm. They are actually clamping down NGOs, on journalists, and everyone who they deem as oppositions. And I believe this is going to cause a lot of problems for even President al-Sisi right now.
Okay. Now, what do you think that, journalists need to do? Because we also saw what happened in the case of Peter Agresti, you know, and Mohamed Fahmy and the rest of them. What do you think that needs to be done so as to make Egypt journalists friendly?
Well, it's going to be a hard one for those journalists, to be honest with you, because it's just like North Korea, what's going on. The state controls the media, controls the journalists. Back to the NGO kind of law. This law says that you have to get like $20,000 to be able to report on anything, to do any kind of activity within Egypt. So the Egyptian Ministry of Interior wants to control every kind of information coming out from Egypt and the authorities, every kind of journalistic work being carried out there. So it's going to be difficult for an average journalist, be international observer or actually local one, to carry on and do all their work, because the government is making it difficult for them to exist. Now, you can believe that it's going to cause a lot of fear within the journalists, and because they've been locked up for 2 years now, that is like the major leader of the journalistic body they have been sentenced. So I believe it's going to be very hard for journalists to do anything, but the Egyptian government has to reconsider what they're actually doing right now when it comes to their laws, when it comes to the policies they are putting in place. What kicked Mubarak out of power is very likely to kick President al-Sisi if he doesn't change his ways and make Egypt a more liberal society, not necessarily liberal as the West, but liberal when it comes to journalistic and press freedom, and even the NGOs would give the right to work. And for example, there's even like a law, protest law, can you imagine, in Egypt, that you cannot protest without getting the permission from the government.
And the NGOs, NGOs play, I mean, critical more like humanitarian roles.
Yes.
So you wonder why they are clamming down on them and rights groups as well.
Yeah, because they believe that the NGOs may be actually be financed by foreign bodies to try and infiltrate the system. But that is not the reality in most cases. The NGOs are doing social and intervention work. They are trying to support in areas whereby the government cannot actually activate its own policies. They are doing supplementary work. So if you now ban NGOs and make it difficult for them to register, there are over 40,000 NGOs in Egypt right now. And if you see all of them have to pay $20,000 to be registered, it's going to be difficult. How much do NGOs get per year? They will rely on foreign funding, and it's going to be very hard for them to exist, NGOs, journalists to exist, and this is going to cause a problem for liberty, freedom, and I believe that Egyptian people have to come together, unite, and stand behind the voice of independence, the voice of freedom.
Yeah, but journalists. But on a larger scale, how do you think that this sort of treatment that the Egyptian authorities are meting out to NGOs, journalists, how will it put Egypt in the eyes of the international community?
Wow, it's really going to paint Egypt in a bad light. basically, see, if there's no press freedom, that means that if there's no freedom of information, that's going to be very, very bad in the world's eye. Just like what's going on around the world today, we've heard the president of Egypt praising Donald Trump and saying that they should not give up on him, that they should not jump to conclusions yet. He's trying to, you know, curry favor with the American government, but they are going to be looking at the kind of policies he's passing across in his own country. I don't believe there's any African nation right now that has such repressive laws actually being put, legislated and passed into law there. In fact, they actually want to put, if it's been passed fully, they actually want to put a police that's going to be watching NGOs, going to be watching journalists, a special task force for that. So the world is watching, and President El-Sisi has to know that he cannot continue in the footsteps of Mubarak and El-Sisi, because they got out of power, they were voted out of power, they were, even a coup took them out of power, and this is what may be his own end if he doesn't change his ways, because the world is going to be very frowned at this vehemently.
But do you see the journalists, the NGOs, you know, resisting this move?
I'm sure they have intentions to do, but you remember that no one wants to go to jail. You know, it has to be the masses, it has to come together.
Because as we saw in the Arab Spring, during the Arab Spring, nobody considered that they would go to jail, nobody considered that they would get hurt, but they all poured out in the streets and resisted.
Exactly. The journalists and the NGOs form just a little percent of the population of Egypt, but if the people can see the value and see the substance that the journalists and also the NGOs are bringing to the table, and rally around behind them, whereby there's a loud protest against the protest law, and say, give us freedom of information, freedom of the press, NGOs, let them do their work. That's when there's hope for Egypt. If not, it's going to be very, very hard. They're going to be seeing a lot of sentencing. They're going to be seeing a lot of scrutiny against the activities of the media and the NGOs, and it's going to make doing humanitarian, social, ethical work in Egypt even more difficult, since it's now about to be passed into law.
Well, Jermaine Sumolu, thank you very much indeed. An African Affairs analyst, thank you for coming to share your thoughts.
Thank you very much.